4 years since George Floyd was killed by Minneapolis police. It was a tragedy that altered the framework of justice all around the country. Even years later, the conversation continues. And today, we have a very special guest. We have Leslie Redman in the house with us, a Minnesota civil rights activist and public speaker, and you're holding an event to honor Floyd with several state leaders. So first, Leslie, one, you've been on the ground doing this work for a long time, so thank you for being here with us.
Of course.
You know, what is it about George Floyd's death, even now years later, being here in Minnesota, that you think that people are not talking enough about?
100%. So thinking back 4 years ago, I often say COVID shut the world down and George Floyd opened it back up, right? We were all ignited. We took to the streets. We gathered. We built bridges instead of walls, right? But 4 years later, it seems like people have forgot. Like they want to forget. It's quiet. People are planning different events on the 25th that have nothing to do with George Floyd. Here in Minnesota, even, I don't think that we honor his memory enough by making sure we're pushing towards social justice and activation.
Tell me a little bit about your journey to get to this point, because Saturday's event will be a pretty big one.
Yes, so we're doing our event on Friday, the Day of Remembrance, the day before specifically, because if you think about it, again, that's the day that our lives changed forever. It was the last day of really being shut in, because the next day we were taken to the streets. And when I think about the Day of Remembrance, again, it's an opportunity to reflect, to heal, to build, to come together, not in a moment of crisis, not because another black man or black woman has been murdered, but because we remember the power is in the people. While there are people pushing back against affirmative actions, against people's rights to just live and be human, we're pushing towards peace, we're pushing towards love, we're pushing towards joy, and we are making sure that people know it's still justice for George Floyd. And the only true justice would be if George Floyd was still alive, and he's not. So we have to keep fighting on his behalf.
Talk to me about just the different structures, right? I know that you're very close with the Floyd family and so many people that have been doing the work. You know, talk me through the journey to get to this point of how it has it been and where do we need to go?
100%. So it's still a grieving process, right? When I think about the buildings burning down to the ground, a lot of them have been rebuilt, but our hearts and our minds are still aching because we can never unsee what we saw 4 years ago, right? When I talk to George Floyd's nephew, Brandon Williams, who'll be flying into town tomorrow to attend our brunch and to activate with us on the ground, he talks about how he's still grieving, right? When the cameras go down, when all is said and done, they lost a person, they lost a family member, they lost a loved one. And a lot of the time we forget that this wasn't just a figure, this wasn't just a moment, this has to be a movement, and we have to keep fighting for justice. And so, yeah, there's been a lot in between, but our hearts and our minds are still aching.
For anybody who is sitting at home and saying, okay, so what can I do today? Obviously, they can go to the event tomorrow, not Saturday, tomorrow. I'm always thinking about that anniversary.
Yes.
But you make a good point. We need to take the space to remember in order to have the anniversary be different, right, year after year.
Yes.
In your world, what do you want this to look like next year and the year after that?
Great question. And the one thing I want to say, too, is the body keeps the score, right? Mm-hmm. There's a book that talks about that. And so that's one of the reasons why we wanted to do the Day of Remembrance before, because I don't know what my body is going to be feeling like Saturday, because it's going to remember that remembrance of George Floyd, right? So right when we're in that in-between, it's important. This is the 4 years. A lot of people say, well, why didn't you wait until the 5 year? Because we need to be remembering every single year, right? We can't wait. We're going to start in the morning with prayer, which I'm so excited about. And it's interfaith, Alexis. We're going to have rabbis and imams and pastors right in City Hall in the lobby praying. How powerful is that going to be, right? We're going to be a couple blocks from George Floyd Square at Sabathany Community Center. That's always been a light in the community for African Americans, making sure that we're activating, that we're telling the stories, that we're coming together with national leaders and local leaders and continuing to push forward. And so 5 years is going to be even bigger, even better. I really want to call for everyone to come back to Minnesota, because again, there are events that happen all over the nation, but this is the epicenter of the change and transformation that has to happen, and Minnesota is in a perfect position to do it.
Thank you, Leslie, for taking some time with us, and of course, we have all the information you need at care11.com/noon.